What is up, you guys? You're watching Sergio's Secret. Before I get started with today's video, I post a video Monday through Friday. Even like on weekends, I put some bonus videos on contemporary and designer fashion. So if that interests you, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any one of my uploads. And we're almost at 50,000 subscribers, so I would appreciate it so much if you guys could subscribe because we are almost there. I'll leave my outfit link down below for you, girlies. I'm kind of feeling the hat. Hopefully the hat doesn't really bother you guys. I think I've worn a hat on the channel just yet, but I mean, I'm living for a little gay yeehaw fantasy moment. I love this little shirt from Isabel Marant. I like how the sleeves are a little bit more puffed out. It makes it more feminine than kind of like a traditional plaid shirt. I'm wearing this Eggwoodie bodysuit and this hat's from Brixton. So today's video that we're going to be talking about today is going to, today's video is going to be all about Gucci. So I have really not made a dedicated video on Gucci. I have hauled Gucci. We have been to the Gucci outlet together. I've shown Gucci throughout my channel, but I physically sat down and made a whole video on just Gucci anything. Gucci is a mega billion-dollar brand. We all know what Gucci is. And so today, let's sit down and let's talk about Gucci handbags. Are they worth it? Are they not worth it? Which ones do I like more than others? We're going to be talking about everything Gucci today. So this may be a little bit more of a longer video, but it is going to be a very chit-chat and informative video. So if you want to grab a snack, you want to grab una agüita, because I've been drinking a lot more water because I'm trying to be a skinny legend. So be strapped because we're going to be talking about Gucci for a hot second. A shot for every time I say Gucci, and I think by the end of it, you're going to start saying Gucci instead of Gucci, okay? I'm just saying, girl. I'm just saying, you know, that Gucci's going to turn into Gucci once you start taking a shot every time I say Gucci, Gucci, Gucci. Go ahead and talk about everything Gucci handbags. So I'm gonna scoot a little bit here on the side, guys. Handbags, I'm gonna be telling you through every collection my thoughts and my opinions, and then at the end I'll give you my overall thought. Collection is from Gucci. This recently came out, I believe within the last 2 weeks, and it is the new collection, and it's called Multicolored. And this one's kind of, most of the pieces of this collection is part of the Marmont collection, so it is gonna have kind of Gigi Marmont hardware throughout the incorporation of these fabric handbags. About this collection, I'm very meh about it, and I'm gonna tell you why. For me, I don't necessarily like the tones of the color. I think that this is very city girl at night. You guys know I am a city girl by heart, and so at night, like if I had it like that, I would buy one and, you know, just wear it at night and call it a day. Me, I find that these colors are more for nighttime. Even like the tones of them, I don't really care for them. I feel like if they did a multicolor, other more beautiful, or I think more beautiful colors that are more desirable to the eye, the tones that they made for this one, personally, I'm not a big fan of it. I don't really, really like it at all. Even I'm thinking about what am I going to think about this 20 years from now when this is considered a vintage bag. I'm not going to be here for it. I really don't like it. I don't like the tones of the fabric. I have tried green one or some of the other colors, and for me, I cannot get through the multicolor collection of Gucci. I definitely see this being at the outlet after a few seasons. Me, I'm not a big fan of it. I don't really like it. And the idea, I think the execution of the colorways is where they went wrong. I find if they were different colors, I feel like it would have been a lot better and it would have been more successful and more executed right. Because of these ones, I'm not a big fan of, and I really don't care for them. New collection of the multicolors, honestly, I don't really care about them at all, if I'm being quite honest. Another collection that I have been seeing a lot of people rock with, well, I've just seen a handful of them, and I am here for them. Like, if I were to get a new bag from any kind of newer Gucci collection, it would be this one. And this is kind of be kind of like the Gucci kind of denim collection. They have a toe in this one. Like, look at that toe. That toe is cute. I'm not the big monogram girl, but I do really like that Gucci toe. I like that denim. It's kind of more darker denim, and I'm here for it. It is $13.50. It comes in the little Jackie version. Like, look at this little Jackie. Look at this Jackie in the denim. I'm here for it. I love it. I'm still here for this entire Gucci denim collection. I've always been a big fan of denim bags. Some people have, some people haven't. I don't have any denim bags in my collection, but I'm really looking forward to add one. The denim one is something that I definitely do want to add. I don't know from what brand. It can be Coach, it can be Gucci, it can be Valentino. Denim collection from Gucci, I actually quite like quite a bit. Also, another one that I really like, which is going to be kind of like the Dionysus version of it. Dionysus. You guys already know I butcher a lot of things. I say things mispronunciation, but you guys know what I mean. Let's get the vibe. This denim collection, I am a big fan of. I'm here for it. I'm living for it. I just love the Gucci denim collection. I think it is so beautiful. I think it is so pretty. Pretty, pretty, pretty. Any denim bags, I'm always a big sucker for. Like I said, this little Prada little denim makeup bag, and I'm always here for it. I'm always living for the little denim fantasy. I love to wear jeans all the time, so for me, this Gucci little denim collection, the moment I saw it, I mean, I'm a jean lover in general, so I already gravitated towards. So probably one of my favorite Gucci collections that I've seen in a very long time. Very, very, very long time. Like, this is something that I could see myself purchasing, like the Dionysus and the denim. Love it. Like, I'm here for it. Está bien bonita, está bien preciosa. Y esta bolsa Gucci, estoy enamorada. And I love it. Like, I cannot say anything bad about the denim collection. We're gonna go ahead and talk about the Marmont collection. This is Gucci kind of classic Marmont collection. I believe it got introduced like in 2015-ish. It's been on storm. People wear it all the time. They have belts, they have shoes. Many variations of the Gucci Marmont collection. And I'm not gonna sit here and lie. I did have those Marmont collections. I had a Marmont crossbody, I had Marmont belts. And for me, I find that I purchased those items for the wrong reasons. I bought them to fit in and they didn't really identify with my personal style and my personal aesthetic. And for me, I find that I see Gucci Marmont still being big for Gucci within the next 5 years. Absolutely yes, I see Gucci Marmont still being with Gucci in the next 5 years. It's still a strong contender for them. People will still be checking out for Gucci Marmont items. For me, I think it's been a little overdone for the short amount of period that the Gucci Marmont has been out. I'm definitely gonna be taking a break from it. Like I said, I bought it for the wrong reasons to begin with. For me, I kind of put a sour taste in my mouth. I don't care about the Gucci Marmont. I actually quite don't like it at all. I think it's been a little overdone. I'm kind of meh when I see it. I'm just kind of like, girl, been there, done. I don't really like it. Like I said, I normally don't talk a lot of negative things about that collections in general. It's just, for me, I bought it for the wrong reasons. It put a bad taste in my mouth, and so that's why I'm not gonna be reaching for a Gucci Marmont item going forward. I don't have any Gucci Marmonts in my collection. So for me, if you have Gucci Marmont, you like it, you rock it, you wear it. Wear your Gucci belt, wear your Gucci Marmont, you wear it. I mean, if you love it, who cares what I say? But for me, the Gucci Marmont's gonna be a no. I feel like it's kind of overdone, it's a little overkill. Kinda not really here for it. So Gucci Marmont's no, and I think there's other Gucci collections that I prefer a lot more than the Marmont. I know one of the $1 million questions that I get asked frequently is, what are my thoughts and my opinions on the Marmont? That I had it, I felt like a poser in it. Wasn't really my actual style. I bought it to blend in, and I noticed that I don't like to blend in. I like to blend out. I like my personality to show out, and I just bought it for the wrong reasons. So therefore, Gucci Marmont is a no for me, but I still think it's going forward. I think it's still strong. If you're still considering Marmont, I think it's a really great contender going forward. So I still see it being a classic for the brand. But as far as for me personally, not my favorite collection. Collection from Gucci is one of my absolute favorites, and this is something that I could see myself adding a handbag into my collection. And you guys already saw me talk about the denim collection. It's gonna be the Dionysus collection from Gucci. Oh my God, I'm here for it. The moment it came out, I've always been a big fan of it. The collection kind of came around the Gucci Marmont, and yes, both are really popular, but I felt that Marmont got overkilled way too much, and that the Dionysus really hasn't. I find that this is gonna be one of their core handbags, and it's still a strong contender. I love it in all the sizes. They have done like little small ones, they have little mini ones, they have larger ones, like, and they have it in the Supreme monogram, they have it in the leathers, they have exotics, and I am really obsessed with the Dionysus collection. I think it is so classic. I think it is so elegantly. I love the hardware on it. I'm not the biggest monogram girl, but I can definitely appreciate the monogram on the Dionysus. I think that it's done so well, so effortlessly, so chic. And like I said, when this came out, it did get taken by storm a little bit on social media. I feel like it never got overkilled as the Marmont or some of the other designer handbags out in the market. For me, it's a classy bag. I think it's a very respectable handbag. I think that it is an absolute 10. If I get to give a handbag a 10 out of 10 out of this Gucci list, it's gonna be the Dionysus. I love it. Está preciosa, está perrona, la del uno. People don't even say that anymore. I just absolutely love the Dionysus collection. I can never go wrong with it. It is such a bread and butter. And even if they discontinue this handbag like 10 years from now, I think it's such an elegantly handbag, even if you do get the monogram version of it. I think it is beautiful, beautiful, beautiful collection. Next collection we're gonna be talking about is gonna be the Ophidia collection. Now the Ophidia comes in kind of like in a bunch of variations as well. They have Ophidia, so anything with Ophidias can be part of like the monogram collection, which is gonna be a coated canvas. I definitely do prefer the coated canvas in Gucci over Louis Vuitton. I find that the Gucci one is a little bit more stiffer, but stiffer in a good way, where I find that it has more structure. I find that the Louis Vuitton monogram is a lot more thinner, and I don't really like the feel of it on the hand. Definitely when you feel the canvas of a Gucci item, I definitely prefer it a lot more, and I find that it's a little bit more stiffer, and I find that the canvas, in my opinion, prefer the Gucci canvas over the Louis Vuitton canvas. Like we're not even gonna act like the print, it's the canvas and the material itself. I find that the Gucci canvas in general, I actually quite like really, really well. That being said, in the Ophidia and the monogram stuff, You know, I would only really do monogram in a Dionysus bag or in the denim collection. The Ophidia monogram, I probably wouldn't do it. That they do really, really good in the Ophidia collection. I think that the Ophidia collection is really well priced still. The Gucci and Saint Laurent has recently had price increases. Still find that the Ophidia is still priced pretty well. I think that is very reasonable. And I think Gucci in general, their handbags, even though they have had price increases, I think for the most part, their handbags are quite reasonable. And I actually quite like the price points of the handbags. That they're kind of like in that Saint Laurent price range. For me, the Ophidia, I like it, but would I go out and buy an Ophidia monogram bag? No. But then they also have Ophidia bag in leather. So in a leather Ophidia, I can see myself getting one. I think Ophidia is a very beautiful collection. You know, ones with the monogram, ones more with the leathers, or with like the exotic. Definitely fall more into the leather category. I definitely do like that one a lot more. For me, as far as the monogram, I like it. And if I see a nice Ophidia bag that I like, I'll compliment it. I'll be like, girly, I love that bag, but it's just not for me. I mean, I wouldn't tell that person it's not for me, but I would compliment on the handbag if it's a nice Ophidia bag that I like. I think it's a nice monogram. I definitely do prefer Gucci monogram over Dior and Louis Vuitton. But a reason, I think it's the tone of the GGs and the placement of it. I like how it's very clean. I find that the LVs are a little bit kind of separated, and then the Diors are kind of like too much together. I find that the Gucci monogram is set very nicely, and it's very proportional. It's not too big, it's not too small, it's not super close with each other, it's not super spread out. I like the Gucci monogram in general, just the way the GGs are spread out personally, and when I feel it inside of my head, do I like the print of it? I definitely prefer the GG monogram all over than, let's say, a Dior or a Louis Vuitton. In my opinion, action is going to be Gucci Off the Grid. And this is supposed to be a take on kind of sustainable materials. I believe the entire bag is made out of recyclable nylon, I believe. Everything in the collection is recyclable. I really like the idea. I really like the concept. I think for me, what killed the bag, the Gucci kind of monogram, I think at the bottom, like where it ends in the G, I just don't like it. It kind of gives me vampire vibes. It kind of gives me like Halloween vibes. I don't know. The placement of the Gucci, I just do not like. I think it absolutely killed the bag. I think if it didn't have that little patch that said Gucci on it, I think the bag would be a lot better. Or if the Gucci was, the font was a lot different. I don't really like the font on Off the Grid on the Gucci. I think that the nylons, I've touched them to the hand, they're very nice. I actually really like kind of like the orangey color in them. For me, I just don't like the Gucci placement on it. It kind of throws my vibe off. I kind of don't really care for it. Collection is going to be the Padlock collection, and this one gives me rich auntie vibes. You're gonna meet your aunt on Easter. You don't really see her too often. You're gonna see her like on Thanksgiving. You see her on Christmas, maybe New Year's, maybe not New Year's, definitely Easter, maybe your birthday party. You kind of invite her because you know she's gonna bring a better gift than all these other people. She's gonna go, mijo, hola mija, or everyone's gonna be, auntie, how are you? It's that fabulous auntie, you know, everything looks super clean, super sophisticated. She has a little Gucci padlock moment on, and for me, I love the padlock. I love it. Only con is that padlock scratches very easily. If you don't clasp it proportionally as you see it, can scratch the padlock, and the scratches can get pretty deep on them. Other than that, I love the bag. I just wish that it wouldn't scratch very, very easily on it, but I know it's a metal on metal, so obviously going to happen as you wear it over time. Slapping it right then and there and keeping it moving, you are unfortunately gonna scratch it. But the padlock collection, you know, they have the more and smaller bags. The smaller bags are super cute. It's a little fun moment. This collection is going to be the Gucci Soho Disco. So this actually came in red as well, but Gucci discontinued the red one, I believe, about a year ago. This one only comes in the nude and the black. This is probably one of the main bestsellers for Gucci. It's not displayed on the floor. So if you go into the Gucci boutique and you see all the handbags and all the collections, you know, everything kind of corresponds. Everything really, really goes. The one bag that you will never see on display at the Gucci store is going to be the Soho Disco. The reason is it's part of the last collection before Alessandro Michele over the house of Gucci, and they kind of revamped everything. That one is part of the previous kind of era. So the only reason why they really have it is because it is such a bread and butter for them. It's such a top seller, and that's why they still have it in those two colors, and they still produce it. It's just such a popular handbag for Gucci, and people are reaching for it. People are loving it. People go for it. People are very, very big fans of the Gucci Soho Disco. But the moment I find that this bag has a decrease, I definitely do see Gucci continuing this bag. But they're gonna pull like a Chanel GST tote, where they're just gonna be one day like, oh, we're just not gonna make it anymore. You can get a Marmont bag, you can get another bag from our collection, but definitely don't see the Soho Disco being there for that long. I said the moment that they can discontinue this bag, the feeling that they will, like, these are the last handbags. Well, the last handbag too, because it comes in nude in the black, but this is the last handbag part of like the previous era. I don't really see it sticking around, if I'm being honest, within the next 5 years. I definitely, like I said, the moment that they discontinue it, they will.
will.
It's a beautiful bag. It's very timeless. It's very classic. It's very sleek. It's very practical. I love the tassel detail on it. I think it's a really great, big fan of that kind of interlocking collection. They've had big bags in them. They've done some super small bags in them. This kind of Soho collection, they've just done so many variations throughout the year. Fortunately, now in 2021, it really comes down to the last Soho Disco, and that will be the last bag that they'll have. So I think it's a really great choice. And if you are looking for a great crossbody, I definitely do prefer this one over the Marmont one all day, every day. The Gucci Soho Disco, I like it and I'm gonna prove it. Next collection for Gucci. She's gonna be the Sylvie 1969 collection, and this one's gonna be more of their premium collection. It's going to be a step up. Remember the Gucci Zumi collection? I believe it got introduced maybe like 2 years ago, and as quickly it came out, as quickly it got discontinued. One thing I did like about the Zumi collection, I love the incorporation of the gold and the silver hardware. I found that the Zumi collection was just very impractical, and it was such a very high price point. It had those little clasps to open it, to get in and out. I just feel like for, especially during COVID and stuff, that it wasn't a really good bag to kind of use. Found that it was very impractical. The price point was a little bit more pricey. What did I say? It got discontinued in like less than 2 years, and these bags were not cheap by any. Like I said, I think they were like over 3 and up, 4 and up. So I definitely see the 1969 collection definitely going in that era. I like it. I love the collection of the 1969 collection. I think it's so perfect. I definitely do prefer the Dionysus collection or the Horsebit collection, which I'll talk about next. Still be 1969 collection. Honestly, it just gives me Zumi 2.0 vibes. Like it, I would hold off on it and wait until they kind of discontinue it, and I would buy it on the pre-loved market. You can actually find really good deals on the Zumi collection, Gucci. So if you are interested in that, I would check the pre-loved market for that. Like I said, they already discontinued it, and at the Gucci outlet, I was there like a week ago, they still have quite a bit of Gucci Zumi stuff in the store. Sylvie, I definitely do see them being in that direction as well. Maybe not as fast as the Zumi collection. This is one of the most classic collections from Gucci, and it's going to be their Horsebit collection. You guys know I love the Gucci loafers. I have 3 of them. I have 2 black ones. I have a mule, I have a actual loafer, and then I have the white ones of them as well. I think that the Horsebit collection, it is so beautiful. I think it is so well done. I got resold in December because, girl, they were going through it. But I think that the Horsebit collection is absolutely beautiful. It is absolutely phenomenal. You can never go wrong with the Horsebit collection. And we're not even talking about the shoes, we're just talking about the handbag. But I just want to show you the beauty of the Horsebit collection. I just think that this is so Gucci, so iconic, and it definitely gives me vintage vibes as well. Tell me you're Gucci without telling me you're Gucci. It's the Horsebit. Like, you can just see the Horsebit, and it doesn't even have to say Gucci. It could be an old leather handbag and have a Horsebit on it. You already know it's Gucci because of the Horsebit. I think it is very classic. I think it is very elegant. Of all the handbags that I'm mentioning in this list, this is by far the most classiest ones. I know, like, the Dionysus, I said it's a very classy bag. It is. And the Soho is a very classy handbag. But if I were to pick one bag in it, one collection, I would definitely say the Horsebit is where it's at. I love it. I definitely really like this version of the Horsebit. I love the incorporation of the monogram, and I like the incorporation of the Horsebit. I just love that it has a little bit of a 2-in-1. It has a little bit of a monogram fantasy moment, but then it also has a leather version. So if you don't want the monogram, you can get an old leather version of it. Horsebit is very beautiful. It's very classic, and I love it. Next collection that we're going to be talking about is going to be the Jackie collection. So they reissued the Jackie collection. It was kind of discontinued. They didn't really produce it anymore, and they recently brought it back about like a year ago. And I love the Jackie, but I think I will say I actually prefer the vintage version of the Jackie. I think that the vintage ones are so pretty. I know we're not talking about really discontinued handbags from Gucci, but since this one did get reissued, they did bring back the Jackie in full force. I will say, as much as I love the newer styles, as much as I like seeing them in the boutiques, that they're so pretty, they're beautiful, they're well made, they're very Jackie O. As much as I love the Jackie bag, I don't know, something about the vintage ones, I just prefer a lot more. It just kind of piques my interest when I see it. When I see a vintage one, I'm just like, dang, that's such a beautiful handbag. Don't get me wrong, I love the new ones, but something about the vintage ones just pops out a lot more at me. So I'm definitely going to recommend the Jackie bag, but I'm gonna recommend vintage one a lot more. Like I said, I'm not really talking about discontinued handbags, but since this one get reissued, I've been getting asked, should I buy a new one or should I buy a vintage one? I definitely do prefer the vintage look of it. I don't know, I find that it looks more authentic, and you can get a really great deal on a Gucci Jackie bag on the pre-loved market. Like, even on Fashionfly, you can find pretty great deals on the Jackie bag. If you are interested in the Jackie bag, check out the pre-loved market, because I think you'd be pretty happy. And like I said, I definitely prefer the vintage over the new ones. Overall, with Gucci, any collections I don't really care for Gucci is the Marmont collection. I don't really care about the Ophidia Monogram collection too hard. And then I also don't care about the Sylvie 1969 collection. But other than that, I really like all the other ones. I like the Jackie bag, I like the Soho Disco, I like the Dionysus bag. I'd love to hear your thoughts and your opinions on Gucci. Do you love Gucci? Do you have multiple Gucci handbags? Do you not own Gucci? Like I said, I only own a very few amount of items from Gucci. I own a pair of optical glasses. I have four Gucci shoes. And then I have a Gucci wallet. But other than that, that's all the Gucci that I have. I could see myself adding Gucci more in the future, but right now I'm really content with what I have. But I definitely want to hear your thoughts and your opinions down below. And if I were to buy one Gucci bag right now, what would it be? I think I would get a matching horse bit bag to match all my horse bit shoes. I just love the idea of the horse bit. And like I said, tell me your Gucci without telling me your Gucci. And yeah, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and leave it here. I'll link every single collection that I talked about today, but I definitely do prefer Gucci than some of the other mega popular brands like Louis Vuitton and Dior. I don't know, something about Gucci I've always liked. I've always had a good feeling about them. Like I said, with every handbag collection, there's always gonna be one or two that I don't like. But for the most part, I give Gucci like a 9 out of 10. I think that their handbags, for the most part, are really well made. They're beautiful. I think a lot of them have that very timeless aspect to them, but also some of them have kind of like a fun twist to them as well. I think Gucci is Sergio Secret approved. I think most of them hit the vibe check, and I'm definitely here for them. So I definitely want to hear your thoughts and your opinions on Gucci down below. Conversation going in the comment section, and I'll see you guys on the next video. Thank you so much for watching this video. I love each and every single one of you. Y los miro hasta la próxima. Bye guys, and take care.